Hello everyone, I am Saveri and I am your mentor for your UGC NET Economics exam. I have done my graduation from SRCC, Masters from CESP JNU, and for the past 1 year I have been working with Indian Statistical Institute as a research associate. So guys, in this video we are going to keep on with our Indian scam series and we are going to learn about Vijay Mallya. So I am going to essentially discuss where did he went wrong. So the first mistake that Vijay Mallya did was he could not diversify. So his father, who was the chairperson of UB Enterprises, knew the importance of diversification. So UB Group was essentially a brewery and was involved in the beverages business. But he knew the importance of diversification and he diversified his business to food and pharma. And both these ventures were also successful. But when Vijay Mallya succeeded his father after his death, he could not diversify this business. He tried to invest in chemical and engineering businesses, but his essential focus was on the brewery section. He has realized that alcohol and the beverages business is the only business in India and it is the only profitable business here. So he started diverting all his funds to the brewery section only. Once he was working there, he realized that in a country like India, advertisement of a beverage, an alcoholic beverage, is not legal. So he started investing in even more enterprises just to advertise for his older business. So he named his villa as Kingfisher Villa, bought an airline and named it Kingfisher Airlines. So he was just advertising for his primary business from all these things. Also, he changed his lifestyle just to promote his one business, that was beverages. Now, the downfall of just investing in one business is when the world will crash for that one particular business, the business in whole would not be able to recover. And that is what happened with him. Second mistake that he did was he did not give due importance to capital. So now Kingfisher Airlines or Kingfisher Beverages is actually a capitalistic firm. So in a capitalistic world, we need to give due importance to capital. But he did not give that importance to capital. So whenever he wanted capital, he would just go to the banks and ask for more money. Now, when he was not able to build his own capital, there was no profit in that business. And he did not give due importance to building his own capital. Now, when he would not be able to make any profits, he would not be able to repay to the banks. And this is the biggest mistake that he did. And the third mistake that he did not give due importance to profits only. So when you are a capitalist or you are an industrialist, you need to sustain your business and profit sustains your business. And he did not give due importance to profit. So now profit margins were falling for him and he was investing in other sectors. This is a wrong move. And when you do that, you would not be able to pay your employees. And that is what happened with him. So a industrialist who couldn't pay his employees or the banks from which he has taken the loans had just one option, to flee the country, and that is what he did. So what are the lessons that every business should take from Mallya scam? One is to diversify its business. Second is to give due importance to capital. And third is to concentrate on profit building. Also, your profits should be at par with the loans that you are taking. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And I will be coming up with these Indian scams videos more. So do comment in the comment box what do you think should be the next topic of the next video. Thank you and have a great day.